don't play it. You know what's good.
Concentrating on what I was going to tell you to put in there, and I forgot, almost forgot to do it.
That's a fucking
crazy deal. It's sharp.
Nobody don't play it like I do, and that's the way he played it. I had four or five more play it. You know what it is when I play it.
Thank you.
sounding pretty good tonight.
What? Martin, huh?
What was that?
Dashed on up with a bottle in my hand. What the hell do you call it?
Give the Fiddle a drink.
Fiddle a drink.
Huh? You're getting good. He's inhaling the fumes about what might be still on the fiddle.
That's where I built that down there in Arkansas. I got some down there. I thought it was pretty good whiskey. I built some on my fiddle.
And it keeps coming up out of there. See, that will tell all you before tonight's over.
Listen, I've got a fiddle at home. You know this Bob Walters, that Nebraska fiddle?
Yeah.
He had a little guy, I forgot the name, played really well. Clyde Walters, you ever meet him? Lived down here with Uncle Bob's nephew.
Yeah.
He died just a few years ago. Lived over there in Branson.
Yeah, lived over Branson.
Well, after he died, his widow gave me one of those fiddles that had belonged to this guy. And on the other side of it, it's all, the varnish is gone, because he had his jollies all the way up to there. And he rubbed them off on the buckles. You know Gordon Peacock?
Yeah,
or you've heard of Gordon Peacock, I imagine, if you don't know. You've heard of him.
You've seen his picture in the post office, if nothing else.
Yeah. I've seen him.
They throw them away anymore.
Oh, yeah, they did?
All them pictures. You know, after 30 days.
Sing on,
Chris. You've got to hide now.
Sing on. Coots.
Okay. There the Mississippi's a-rollin' on that sunny Sunday. Thank you.
Just do another while you're
trying to. I don't know what I'm doing.
It would have been better for a small town there. Thank you.
I heard it. You got that down. You got that down. I don't think so. I made
our bag
back
for it.
How you
do? One loaf of bread.
There's Fiddle.
Right.
Yeah.
And a long one.
Yeah.
I didn't
have to go to that. See, you get so much stuff in there.
Yes.
Yeah.
Men are pretty good.
All right, let's just have it then.
We're going to get three, four.
That sounds a lot like C.
Thank you.
sound right here?
Yeah, I've got the wrong one somewhere.
Isn't that
two different words? It ain't been strung up there, by the way.
Is that two different?
I ain't got no.
Is that a fiddle tune?
Yeah. One is just loud, man.
And I've heard somebody.
That's a roller. I've got a place to play later.
Is that
black water? Yeah. Huh?
Was that
black water? Yeah, it's black water, but I wasn't playing it. I didn't have
it. It's like two different worlds.
Well,
yeah.
He made it on that song.
I didn't have no roller.
Oh, Johnny.
That's the old original.
That's what it
is. You know where I
heard. New strains. I don't know if they're even in.
We
dreams. Mm-hmm. I had any.
I've got one more and I'm going to quit. The old time, you can call it.
Thank you.
see if I can sing it. M A.
Thank you.
Even Sally Ann's kind of a take on, you know.
I heard it play.
Bye.
I never even caught a pilot.
Can you say?
That's been a long time. I remember now. That was over there on. That store there. Yes, I think at least 2 or 3 years ago.
Yeah.
I've still got that thing back there all the way.
Thank you. Jones is, that's so fast over there. That, it's called Ladies Fancy, you know, the record is. That's supposed to be pretty fast. That's nice, that's just about the right speed.
Let's play Flowers of Venus. Nobody else knows the chords. Nobody knows the chords for that. And I'm not sure I can get it started. I played it last night, though. How's it go? Oh, yeah.
there, of course.
Thank you. Are you up for some bread yet?
Oh, not yet. Save that one for last.
I might go to sleep.
Well, I heard her woman. I went to that talk she gave. I went to that Hubble's talk.
Oh, yeah?
At the Nature Center here. She read the entire chapter of one of her books. I mean, I don't know how long she went on. Which was, she could have just cut it down and talked about it, you know, and then the discussion afterwards was pretty interesting.
And when was that, Saturday?
Brandon, you know Charlie Wills. He's the bee. So that's Thelma's cousin. Or is married to Telford's niece. He's a beekeeper, he knows her, and he said she was considerably straightened up from when he last saw her a few years ago, you know. But she was a pretty interesting person.
Was that Saturday?
Now don't, you never bring that book, so I'm going to have to come down and get it. So.
When was that? If you had told me you was coming, I'd have
just be quiet. I was going to have to come down and get it, because I can't get you to bring it. I've got to have an excuse. It was okay, but she went on and on, you know. I've read the chapters on it.
When was it?
A couple of weeks ago. Friday the 13th.
It was an interesting book.
She read it out of this spring, not the bee book, but the other one. We saw her the other night in the restaurant.
Yeah. Yeah, I never think about that.
That's a great
tune. That's a good tune. Most of them.
Oh, I was listening to that McNew on the way down here. You sent the tape of him on one side and what's Davenport? Who's the other guy?
There's Clyde Davenport.
Davenport, yeah, that was on the other side. Banjo and fiddle both. Yeah. And then McNew's on the other side.
Oh, Clyde plays some good. That one tape, that kaleidoscope, is a well, good tape. I didn't care as much for the rest of them.
In fact, there's a couple of you play on there. There's three or four you play that are on those two. I mean, unusual.
Walter McHugh played a lot of Doc Rogers.
Huh?
Walter McHugh knew Doc Rogers.
He knew Doc Rogers.
Yeah. He's got a bunch of that Yellow Barber and some of those on there.
Oh, really?
The cat come back, yeah, puts a skull in it. That's about the best version that I've ever heard.
You need a knife? Yeah.
I'm pretty bitter.
Tear it off here.
There you go.
That'd you just well.
Right side.
You mean you can tell the difference?
No, I enjoy playing that.
You got your gears in there.
Yes,
no.
Yeah.
Yeah, make these hard
games. You ever
unearth those?
They make that damn stuff. Everything anymore.
Yeah, part of one.
You need dynamite to get into anything. I can't open
it. But it's still not really bad.
Thank you. Thank you.
Sometimes them suckers, do they walk on top of the snow? No, raise your foot.
Oh, these things. Yeah. Yeah, it might be smart not to wear them in the snow, I guess.
Well, I'll throw a tool cake. Well, it's Friday night.
I always see her shoes laying somewhere out of the
way. I was going to say, man, in this snowy weather.
You got them damn things that you can just slip a lot on, and all you do is just go one way. No,
she's down there.
Some people are kind of worried about those shoes, I think, when they saw them out there in the middle. I don't know.
We were riding a van, riding in front of you. We got a
right. Let's play something else before they request.
Say, that's good. I never thought of that. Dude, now do we have to pay him when he comes back? That's
oh, yeah. Give him a tip. Don't look up on the
thank you.
Waltz. Flying Indian Waltz.
I could play the Flying Indian Reel.
What? Reel?
Flying Indian Reel now.
Kind of like the St. Anne's Waltz.
I guess.
St. Anne's Shot. Well, he was in Illinois, that's where he's at. He went to Illinois. Is that the same thing, that music?
Yeah, he worked at the old town school of folk music. Yeah, he was in someplace up in the house.
Is that where he is
now? He still lives in Chicago.
Yeah, I thought he changed that.
Doug, I'm gonna play your tune.
Thank you.
hard to play the fiddle on your nose around. I get my elbow shape sometimes, play the square dance.
That makes the bow slippery, don't it? That makes the bow slippery, don't
it? Start another. You wait very long, Gordon, and start some big tail on her. Play fast.
Play fast. All right. Okay.
What?
Shelly's got mud between her toes.
Yeah.
Thank you. All right. Don't you try it? You never did.
I never did food with it. That was out.
What was that?
I know, yeah, I know.
What was that?
Sadie. I finally learned that from Alton Jones. It was always my favorite tune. I never could
play. She asked me why I didn't play it. I said that was Alton's tune.
Yeah. Well, what? I thought there was another tune that Art played they called Sadie.
I mean,
what was that?
Can you hobble
Sadie?
Around to that?
Sadie, you mean?
Yeah.
I just played it.
Sport, can't you hear it?
Yeah, I heard it. I've been with that all night and I didn't know what to think about it.
It's got a different name up the Springfield. What's the other name of that station? You know what?
Thank you.
one just stopped me and he'd go.
What's that called?
Pretty Waltz. Fiddler's Waltz.
Fiddler's Waltz. That's just half of it, but the other half, nobody but Howdy Forster ever played anyway. And it's Zach Perlman.
Howdy got pretty fancy something. Howdy got fancy something.
Oh, God. Sound like it's Zach Perlman on that. On the mother part. Huh? I want to awful bad, but I can't try to keep from getting it tangled up.
Well, I was having the same. I tried to do that little thing down there with the table this morning, and I got it tangled up.
It's so damn much like Wednesday night.
Yeah, it is.
Play something
to
see.
We're going to
be leaving here before too long.
Play something to see.
Yeah.
See. I usually hear all kinds of protests.
I'm sorry to say, I'm doing this just for a week so I can get out of trouble here.
Play I don't love nobody
to
see.
Yeah. Play if I play it at all, that's the word to see.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Waltz.
Kemp's nice Waltz.
That's a neat Waltz.
No. It's on Charlie's tape.
Oh, it is?
Called it Norma Lou's. He called it Norma Lou's Waltz.
Who does?
Charlie.
Charlie Waltz?
Morning.
Yeah.
Morning, please. I don't know what Waltz is. Please push on this.
No.
I thought that's what you wanted.
I got it.
You bought
it? I've been for years. Yeah, I've been for years.
We're still talking about this album over here.
What is it?
The Old Virginia Fiddlers.
It's a good album.
Looks like
discs or something.
You quitting already?
Cool. Well, I got to get
let's play one more. You always got to play one more. I don't care when you start doing. You always got to play one more. I wanted to hear a Put Your Little Foot, not just about your speed.
Somebody played that, and then they go to D and
play in D, and then back to the probably so. Usually somebody does nearly everything.
That's right. True. Oh!
Play, Louisville breakdown.
What?
Louisville breakdown.
Chairs get harder all the time.
Send out and get your suppers. And the foreman says, well, bring five suppers and one bale of hay. Walk up as stubborn as a mule. I don't believe I feel like fun telling stories by myself, really. I don't feel like I could cut the mustard, really. I don't.
Tell that one you told me when I first got here about the doc that wore the suit and everyone. I said, you've been preaching or something.
Oh, yeah. And just a true event in the old Kirbyville, there was a little Dr. Anderson, and he had been a surgeon in the Southern Army, and he's a real gentleman. And he was going from his little home up to his office one day, and he had a Panama hat, the linen suit, the loafers on the store porch, they was started to tease him. He said, Doc, where are you going to preach today? Where's the wedding? One thing and another. He straightened up pretty soon, and he looked them over, and he said, it's a damn poor town that can't afford at least one gentleman. I want to tell you a little bit about it. Used to be, before they built all the dams, I didn't have money to take a vacation, so we'd camp on the White River. down at the big spring, Hickey Spring, they called it, Miguel Spring. And so we camped for a week, and I borrowed a bit of same from Bob Gideon, and I set my truck line and had the bin of traps and all that. And so Garland Sims came down to the distance with us, him and his wife. And he ran afoul of the game warden one time. he had that little old game ball book in his pocket all the time. So he looked at me over my fishing outfit. And he said, "Well, you got to try it along the stretch clear across the river." I said, "That's against the law." He said, "How many hooks you got at all?" I said, "The whole book, box full, about 50. Wasn't I supposed to have 20? And he said, "You're better saying, how long is it?" And I said, "Oh, about 20 feet. He said, "You're supposed to be 12 feet long. And said, "You haven't got your name and number on your minnow bucket or on your minnow safe." Well, after he left, I was waiting around that river, and I got thinking about that. And I made up a little song. I can't sing anymore, but this is what I said. They took me to the courthouse. The judge was a crank. I had my trot line stretched from bank to bank. They took me to the courthouse. I'm down in jail. There ain't nobody to go my bail. Took me to the courthouse and put me in jail. And I caught a little catfish and gave the catfish away. Went on and all about the fishing always. I was violating the law. I called that the conservation blues.
Doug, there's four or five people here that's not heard that story about the school. Just teaching school over at Beach Creek.
Hootie Jones, yeah. Well, I've told that all over the world, see.
Well, it's worth retelling.
Well, it's a true story. You know, Vance Randolph said we always lie to strangers. We lie to one another too sometimes. You know, but this happened to me. I was I was just 18, teaching a big Greek school in the south part of Taney County. And just across the creek was Arkansas. And they had about 6 months school, we had 8 months school. So after school was out over at Daybury School, some of those children would come over to our school. So after school was out in Arkansas, long march, I looked across the footlong, and there's three little boys coming with their little surf bucket dinner pails. They came up on the school ground, and I rang the bell for books. Took the teacher's register, I still have it home, and to get their names and the ages and grade. Well, it came the first little boy, and he was Faye Jones, and he was 12 years old and got his grade. They went to the next little boy, and he was Garland Jones. And then the third little boy was real heavy set, almost an albino. And he had a voice like a man. I didn't realize until I started talking to him. And I said, "Little boy, what's your name?" He said, "Hootie Jones." I said, "Hootie, how old are you?" 5 years old. I said, "Hootie, you know your ABCs?" "Well, hell no, I ain't been here 5 minutes." This happened to be another true story. Before they built the big dam up there, there was a pothole there below the bridge, the saloon there. And there was a boy down there digging worms. And there was an old carp out there in that little pocket of the water. And he had that potato fork out there trying to kill that carp. And old Fred Baker was up on the bridge with his glasses, and he was spying on him, and you had some experience, Fred.
Sorry.
So he was spying on these glasses, and he
hung over in a few years.
Hated him in the court. And I tried every way in the world to get him to lie, but he wouldn't. And anyway, the definition for a gig is it has to have a bar on it. So I questioned old Fred if this had been filed out to have a bar on one thing or another. And finally, Judge Barr was the judge. After it was all over, why, he set the boy free. And he got up, and I thought he was going to thank the judge, but he said they'd confiscated his tater fork, you know. He said to the judge, said, now, by God, I want my tater fork.
Well, it's been out of Kirbyville. I mean, it's
like... They're making another one down there.
They're moving it. Yeah, they didn't have it moved.
No, it isn't moved yet. They're working on the building,
Jim.
What book are you talking
about? Huh?
What book are you talking about?
Not Doug's books.
Oh, yeah.
We've got them.
I've got two.
They're nappies.
Yeah, we've got them.
Run over here. Run over here.